This video of our Python tutorial series, we are discussing about class and objects in Python and how Python classes and objects are created. At the very beginning of our tutorial, we studied that Python is an object-oriented programming language. So, is object oriented. So, what is object oriented programming? Okay. So, almost everything in Python is an object. Object-oriented programming language, and almost everything is an object, and every object has its own properties and methods. Okay, so this is how object-oriented programming can be understood. We will also have a look at some other examples which will make it more clear to us. And a class is like a constructor. Like a constructor of doing what? A constructor of creating objects. Okay. So just like blueprints are there to create buildings and products. So similarly, a class is there to construct objects. So on the basis of class, we can construct an object. So let's take a very simple example. Let's consider a very simple example using which we can understand classes and objects more easily. We are using this container, and this represents our class. Okay, and it has two things mainly. Class has mainly two things. One is your data, and another thing is your methods. So whenever we talk about a class or object-oriented programming is dependent on classes and objects. Okay, so classes contain the basic definitions for objects, and whatever definitions or properties or methods are defined inside a class are inherited by their objects. Okay, so we will use some other methods to understand it. So this is a class. Okay, so now it is clear that whenever we create a class, it will have some data and some methods. Okay, now let's assume we have take an example of car. So car is a class. Okay. What kind of data? So if it's a class, then as per our discussion, it should have data and it should have methods. So what kind of data a car can take and what kind of methods or functions a car can have. Okay. So suppose we are writing make. What is the make or brand of car? Model, probably something like color, maybe top speed, or simply the running speed or top speed, whatever. So this is our car, and this car has following data. This car can take following data: make, model, color, and speed. And what methods a car can take? What functions a car can take? It can be start. Right now we are not defining these functions, but you know, if you have to define start, we can do something like start. If we are in Python, we can say def start, and ignition is equal to 1, yes, or true. So on ignition, whenever someone is calling this function on their object, so our class knows what to do with it. Or the object, which is the part of this class, will inherit the definitions of this functions. Okay. So start, another function can be move. Okay. So whenever someone says move, so what are class, it will take the definition of class, and whatever we have defined inside move function, our object will do that. Stop, so ignition is equal to 0, and break, move is equal to whatever is defined inside move. Suppose inside move we have defined acceleration is equal to 1. So inside your stop function or inside your brake function, you will have acceleration is equal to 0. So we are using some simple and common definitions to understand classes. So this is a class, and now we can have objects also. So this car can have any number of objects also, and all those objects will have the same definition. So let's say we have Honda MH. So we write something like this, or we write black Honda MH. So this is an object of this class, black Honda Amaze. Obviously there are syntax in Python to create an object, but so we will have proper definitions for creating an object, but black Honda Amaze. So we can simply relate it with our data of inside this class, that black is the color, Honda is the make, and Amaze is the model. So this is the concept of classes and objects. So we can write something like, so something, how to create these objects inside Python, or what is the syntax, what is the syntax of creating objects inside Python. So we will do that in our next chapter, which will be about creating the syntax of classes and how to create objects in Python. Okay, so wait till the next class and please follow these videos.